Hi friends, welcome back to new session. So in this session we are going to discuss about transformer as constant flux device topic. If you observe, in the last video we discussed about features of ideal transformer, and so in the features of ideal transformer we discussed some points. If you see, winding resistance is assumed to be zero in ideal transformer, but in fact winding will be having some resistance. Okay, so because of that winding resistance will be having some effect on the operation of transformer. That topic only we had seen in the last video, effect of winding resistance on the operation of transformer we discussed. Okay, and one more thing guys, if you see ideal transformer, leakage flux generally is assumed to be absent, but practically leakage flux will be there. So effect of leakage flux on the operation of a transformer, one more topic is there, that we'll discuss in the next video. So before that, I need to discuss about this topic, transformer as a constant flux device. See here, for explaining this topic, I had taken this figure. So let me take a transformer core like this, having two windings, primary winding, because this is the winding which is connected to the source. That's why you can call this winding as the primary winding, having number of turns N1. And this secondary winding, because I am just going to connect this winding to the load, that's why this winding can be called as a secondary winding. Okay guys, now see, let me connect a time variant voltage source to the primary winding of transformer. You know, in transformer generally which type of supply will be giving? So AC supply, nothing but time variant voltage source will be connected. So V1, nothing but time variant voltage source is connected to the primary winding of transformer. So initially transformer, if you see, there is no load connected to the secondary winding. Okay, so under no load condition, what is the current taken to the transformer? In fact, it is I0. Under no load condition, current taken by the transformer is nothing but how much here? I0, no load current. Nothing but what is the other name for no load current? Exciting current. So under no load condition, current taken by the transformer is nothing but I0. So that I0 I just represented here. I0 is nothing but no load current, or one more name is, what is that? Exciting current. I told you already this one. I0 bar is equal to what guys? I mu bar plus IW bar. Nothing but I0 is the vector sum of I mu and IW. Okay. So I think I had given an expression for this I mu also. I mu is what? Magnetizing current. It is used to magnetize the transformer core, or I can say it is used to produce flux in the transformer core. And IW is nothing but core loss component of no load current, okay, or working component of no load current. IW is used to represent the core losses, or I can say iron losses in transformer. This already we discussed in the previous videos. So now please see, I already told you what is the value of I mu guys. 4 to 5% of full load current, 4 to 5% of full load current. And what is the value of IW? Is only 1 to 2% of full load current, right? 1 to 2% of full load current. So it's a common sense that among IMU and IW, which value is more? IMU is more. So if you compare IMU and IW, I can neglect this IW. That means what? In place of I0, simply we can write approximately IMU also we can write, no problem. I mean, if I neglect IW, okay. Or if you see, what is our present topic? Transformer as a constant flux device. So it is dealing with the fluxes, right? So IMU is having some role with the flux. Nothing but IMU is used to create some flux in the transformer core. So definitely I should indicate this I mu, whereas IW, if you see guys, IW is used to represent core losses. Okay, core losses, it is nowhere related with I can say flux. Therefore I can neglect this one for present topic. So if I neglect IW in this I0, so in place of I0 approximately I can write what? I mu. Okay, so I mu wrote. Okay, now please tell me, for this sense of winding, so if I wound like this, suppose if it is a transformer transformer leg, if I wound like this, so this is nothing but winding is going from front side of the core and it is coming from back side of the core limb, I can say, core leg, I can say. Okay, therefore this end is nothing but what? I can say front end. And what about this end? Can be called as back end. Okay, so what about this end? Front end. And what about this end? Back end. So regarding this front end and back end, nothing but sense of winding, all those things clearly we explained in types of magnetic coupling. Please try to refer that topic so that you'll be having some idea regarding the front end, back end, all those things. Okay, Now tell me guys, where, this IMU current is entering at front end or back end? Initially here it is entering at a front end. So now tell me, if you want to know the direction of core flux which is induced because of IMU, we have to use a right hand thumb rule. In right hand thumb rule, I told you thumb indicates direction of flux and wrapped fingers indicate direction of current. So please try to be very careful here. Suppose if you take transformer core, limb or leg like this, when current is entering at front end, if current is entering front end, this is the front end, this can be taken as back end, front end, back end. If current is entering at front end, your wrapped fingers you have to show like this. Okay, suppose if current is entering at back end, you have to show like this, because for a core leg, this is what I can say front end, and this can be called as back end. If current is entering at front end, you have to show wrapped fingers like this, then flux will be upwards. Suppose if current is entering at back end, so flux will be downwards. So please try to be careful here. So now tell me, where current is entering in this case? It is entering at front end. So obviously front end means, if you take this transformer core limb, it is entering at a front end, leaving at back end. So let me show that arrow mark which is entering at front end. Yes, let me show this arrow mark. Entering at front end, leaving at back end. That back end direction of, whatever the current leaving at back end, that I cannot show. Is it clear? So I can only show direction of current which is entering at front end. This arrow mark is anything but current direction of current entering at front end, and I cannot show direction of current leaving from back end. Once again, I can show direction of current entering at a front end. I cannot show current direction leaving at back end. Simply, I can show direction of current which is entering at a front end, and here it is leaving from back side is leaving. So this is the direction of I mu current. So simply, if you apply a right hand thumb rule, so current is entering at front end, so you have to show wrapped fingers like this, as I told you. So direction of flux will be upwards. Okay, and before that guys, you tell me, so this is nothing but this arrow mass indicates direction of current which is entering at front end of the coils. So that direction of current I can also show in the form of cross and dot. How? See, as I told you, since current is entering at front end, I have to show wrapped fingers like this. So wrapped fingers, if I show like this, it is entering, leaving. Entering means into the board, current entering into the board, coming from the board here. Entering into the board means cross, coming from the board means you have to show dot here. Okay, so don't confuse. This arrow marks indicates direction of I mu, and this cross and dot also indicates direction of current I mu, which is entering here, which is leaving here. Now if I show wrapped fingers like this, direction of flux will be upwards. So let me show direction of flux which is in upward direction in this manner. So I am just showing here this arrow mark. Upward arrow mark indicates what? Direction of core flux pi, which is induced in the produced in transformer core due to I mu. So it's upward means, yes, direction of flux pi, core flux will be like this. Okay, right, and it is linking with the secondary winding also. Okay, right, now see guys, here it is completing path like this. Now it is coming like this, means that secondary winding direction of pi will be downwards. Okay, now tell me, if V1 is time variant voltage source which is connected to the primary winding of transformer, and IMU is time variant current, okay, and because of IMU, flux produced in transformer core is time variant. Whenever flux is time variant and the conductors are stationed in transformer, because of relative time variation, which already explained in basics topic, because of relative time variation, where conductors are stationary and magnetic field is time variant, rate of change of flux linkage will be possible, EMF will be induced. That EMF, I'm calling it as primary induced EMF in a primary winding, E1. Don't confuse with this arrow mark. I'll show direction of I mean, which is leaving from bracket here. Okay, right. So this is what direction of, this is what I can say, EMF induced in primary winding. Okay, now please try to refer Lenz law topic, which I told in previous videos. There, if you observe clearly, if V1 is a voltage source here, suppose if it is phase and if it is neutral, or I can say phase can be represented for your understanding point of view plus, neutral can be represented for your understanding point of view minus, If phase is here, neutral is here, or V1 is a voltage source, and if it is front end is here, back end is here, I clearly explained it. Polarities of this EMF E1, you'll get like this, here plus and here minus. Okay, so please try to refer Lenz law topic, there I explained clearly. So how I got this plus symbol here, how I got minus symbol here, okay? There is no need to repeat once again here, okay? Please try to refer that video. And you please tell me in primary side, what is the relation you can write? Ideally, V1 bar equals to, generally E1 bar is correct only, but according to circuit theory, according to field theory, if you observe clearly, because of this E1, you'll get some current. That current will oppose your IMU. That current opposition also clearly I showed in Lenz law topic. So to show that opposition, I just mentioned here minus symbol. This minus symbol is due to what I can say? It is due to Lenz law. It is due to Lenz law. That opposition has to be shown in the equation. So that's the reason why you'll get a V1 bar equals to minus E1 bar. Please, I request you try to refer Lenz law topic if you are having doubt in indicating plus and minus symbol here, okay? And if you are having doubt, V1 bar equals to minus E1 bar equation, please try to refer that video, okay guys? Now, yes, phi is linking with the primary winding, rate of change of flux linkage will occur, EMF will be induced, okay? Now, same flux will come and link with the secondary winding having number of turns N2. Is it clear? Here also, rate of change of flux linkage will be there, where flux is time variant, conductors are stationary. So here also EMF will be induced. So EMF, I'll take it as E2 is the EMF induced in the secondary winding. Is it clear? Right. Now please try to follow clearly. So after this point, because of this E2, if there is closed path, please try to let me repeat. If because of this E2, you will get current I2 if there is closed path in secondary side. So let me provide closed path by placing load across secondary winding. So let me provide closed path by connecting load across secondary winding. This is what I can say, load. Okay, load. So what I said, because of this E2, you will get current in the secondary winding, nothing but you will get current I2. Okay, so I'll write here once again clearly for your understanding point of view. V1 is time variant, IMU current taken with the transformer primary winding time variant, flux produced in transformer core time variant. So it links with the primary winding, rate of change of flux linkage E1 proportional to d by dd of flux linkage means what? N pi. What are the number of turns in primary? N1, core flux pi, rate of change of flux linkage will be there, EMF will be induced. And one more thing guys, same flux will go and link with the secondary winding, here also rate of change of flux linkage will be there, E2 proportional to d by dt of N2 into pi. Okay, and because of this E2, if there is closure path, you will get some current I2. You will get some current I2. Yes, closed path is there. Definitely current will come into picture. Now, tell me, according to Lenz law, direction of E2. Nothing but E2 is nothing but primary induced EMF. Okay, sorry. V2 is nothing but second induced EMF. So, direction of EMF induced in transformer may be primary or maybe secondary. So, direction of EMF induced in transformer windings is given by Lenz law. So, tell me, direction of EMF E2 is such that, so because of this E2, you will get some current I2. Because of this current, you will get some flux pi2. You get some flux pi2. Now, this pi2 becomes now effect and cause nothing but this flux becomes what I can say? Cause here. This flux becomes a cause now. So according to Lenz law, effect opposes changes in cause. See, this pi2 is because of this I2. I2 is because of this E2. E2 is because of this pi only, no? So, this is what I can say pi2. And this is what I can say what? I can say pi2 can be taken as effect. Pi can be taken as cos. So, according to Lenz law, so pi2 opposes pi. So, tell me here. pi to opposite pi means how I have to show this pi direction is downwards by here. So pi 2 should be upwards. Pi should be upwards. Then only you can say that pi 2 is opposing your pi. Your pi 2 is opposing your pi. I can say so it is upwards. Yes, it in the core direction of pi 2 is in this manner. Pi 2 I said pi 2. Okay. So right. Let me once again here also. Let me show direction of pi 2 is downwards, which is opposing core flux pi. Okay. Now tell me guys, if I want pi to upwards here, this red color upwards. So if I want pi to flux direction upwards, in what direction I too might have flown? Here some people will be having some confusion. So some people are asking doubts, sir, do you get I2 after pi2? No. First of all, we will get E2. Because of E2, you will get I2. Then only you will get pi2. But you may get one doubt. You may get one doubt. Sir, then why you are showing pi2 initially before indicating I2? So for your understanding point of view, what Lenz's law will say, direction of E2 or direction of I2 is given by Lenz's law. So direction is given such that because of E2, whatever I2 is produced, because of this I2, whatever flux pi2 is produced, this pi2 will oppose pi. So that's why directly I'm just showing a pi2 opposing pi. So if it is a pi is downward, I'm just showing pi2 upward. Now tell me guys, if I want pi2 flux upward, if I want pi2 to be in a upward direction, now tell me in what direction I2 might have entered in the secondary winding. Please try to see this one. Right hand thumb rule, if you observe clearly, thumb I am saying this red color upwards. If I want pi2 in upward direction, in what direction your I2 might have entered in the coil? Tell me, it is backward or back end or front end? Where current is entering I2 current? It is entering at the back end. Is it clear? So if I show like this means what is the meaning? If I take this one as a core limb or leg, if pi2 is upwards here, so in what direction I2 might have entered? Back end. So which one is back end here? This one. So it is entering here. This is what I can say direction of I2. In fact, because of E2, immediately we will get I2 if there is a closed path. Then pi2 will come. But for your understanding point of view, first I am just showing pi2, then I am showing I2. Okay, don't confuse between I2 and pi2 who is coming first. So no doubt, I2 will come, then only pi2 will come. But for your understanding point of view, initially I am just showing pi2. Then corresponding to that direction, I am just deciding the direction of I2. Okay guys, now tell me, whenever yes current is entering at back end, it is entering at back end. See, it is entering at back end, leaving at the front end. See, entering at back end, that I cannot show, right? Leaving from front end, so that I can show here. Once again, entering at back end, leaving from front end, leaving from front end. See, entering at back end, leaving from front end, entering at back end, leaving from front end. Yes, leaving, 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 leaving. This is what direction of I2. Okay, now always you know current always flows at load from plus to minus. This can be taken as load voltage. I'll take it as a V2. V2. Okay guys. Okay, and I think if you refer once again Lenz's law topic, there also clearly explained polarities of E2 also here plus, and here I just mentioned minus, plus minus, here plus minus. In secondary side, simply you can write E2 bar equal to V2 bar. It is not minus V2 bar. Whereas in primary, it is V1 equals minus E1. In secondary, E2 bar equals V2 bar only. So for these two equations, I had given clearly explanation in Lenz's law topic. So I had taken same sense of winding. Front end I had taken, back end I had taken, front end I had taken, back end I had taken. Okay. So please try to refer that video so that you will be having some clarity. Okay, right? Now see guys. So here if you see up to this position, what is the position of core flux? See this core flux, whatever pi is there, that core flux is demagnetized by this pi2. See what is the direction of pi and pi2? They are opposing, no? That means core flux will be reduced. I can say core flux is demagnetized. Whenever core flux will be reduced, now tell me what will happen to power transfer capability from primary winding to secondary winding? It will reduce. Is it clear? Which is not desirable. So obviously what will happen? So now this pi2, I said because of this E2 I'll get I2, because of this I2 you'll get pi2. Okay, This pi t is opposing, your pi it is coming and linking with once again primary winding. So please try to understand, because of this pi 2 once again in primary side, because of this pi 2 you will get a, you know, some EMF. Let me call that EMF as EZ, something like that, EZ. And because of this EZ, you will get some current, let me call it as I2 dash. What is that? I2 dash. Because of this I2 dash, once again you will get some flux. What is that flux? I'll write it as pi 2 dash. What is that? Pi 2 dash. Okay guys, now once again Lenz law. So now in this case, this becomes effect, pi 2 dash becomes effect, cos becomes this pi 2. So according to Lenz law, this effect opposes changes in cos, pi 2 dash will oppose pi 2. Is it clear? So for to show that opposition, please try to see clearly, pi 2 is opposed by what I am saying, pi 2 dash. So tell me, what is the direction of this pi 2 in here? It is downwards, right? It's downwards. So now pi 2 dash should be what? Upwards. Pi 2 is opposed by pi 2 dash because of Lenz law. If pi 2, this radical is downwards, don't see this black color flux, don't see this core flux here. So for this pi 2 dash, cos is now pi 2, it is not pi. Initially for this pi 2, cos is a pi, that is okay. Now for this pi 2 dash, cos is this one, not this one, okay. So now pi 2 means this red color arrow mark, so pi 2 should be opposed by pi 2 dash. So if it is downward arrow mark, it should be upward arrow mark. Yes, this is the direction of pi 2 dash, which is opposing whom here, which is opposing pi 2, this is a red color. So this flux can be called as pi 2 dash. It is coming, and once again it is opposing what I am saying, pi 2, no, red color. So this is upward here, so it should be downward here. So yes, this is the direction of a pi 2 dash. Is it clear, guys? Now tell me, if I want pi 2 dash to be in upward direction, this green color, okay, like this, okay, in green color. Now in what direction your I2 dash current might have flown? Because initially I2 dash will come, then only pi 2 dash will come, no? So now tell me, if I want pi 2 dash upwards, see right hand thumb rule, if I want pi 2 dash upwards, in what direction your I2 dash might have flown, or I2 dash might have flown here. Once again, it is entering at a front end, no? It is entering at front end. Front end with this one. Just like wherever I mu is entering, like that I2 dash also will enter. So therefore I can say I mu plus I2 dash, or I can say I0 plus I2 dash. Both equations are correct only. So I told you initially, in place of I0, why I wrote simply I mu? In place of I0, why I wrote simply I mu? If I neglect I double U, I simply taken I mu. Okay, these two equations are same only. Okay. So now tell me guys, so I mu plus I2 dash becomes how much? I mu plus I2 dash becomes how much here? I1. So let me show front end here. Next, I0 plus I2 dash becomes how much here? I1. Okay, now please. Yeah. Now tell me, so this direction of I2 dash, which is just like direction of I mu. I mu is entering at front end, I2 dash also entering at front end. That's why they are in phase. So I am writing I mu plus I2 dash equals to I1, I am writing. Okay. This is what I1 is in primary winding current, I2 is in secondary winding current. Now tell me, is it clear up to this? Okay. Now, so if you try to observe clearly, initially I am having this black color flux. Then we are getting this red color flux, pi 2. Suppose if green color flux, pi 2 dash is not there, this pi is demagnetized with this pi 2, which is not desirable. So there is lot of importance because of this pi 2 dash. Because of this pi 2 dash only, so whatever demagnetizing effect is there in core, that was neutralized now. Because initially, see, pi was demagnetized by this pi 2, no? So if pi 2 dash is not there, pi 2 dash means how you will get I 2 dash. If I2 dash is not there, then definitely in core pi is demagnetized by this pi 2, which is not desirable. So there is a lot of importance because of this I2 dash and pi2 dash. Okay. So pi2 dash is coming and it will neutralize the demagnetizing effect. How? Let me show that. So I think I'm just going to erase this portion, whatever I just wrote up to now. Okay. Right. Now tell me. So ultimately what we need here in transformer core, always core flux should be pi. There should not be any demagnetizing effect. Is it clear? That means what? So if I want to maintain transformer core flux constant, that is only our heading, transformer as constant flux device. If you want to maintain a transformer core flux constant irrespective of load changes, irrespective of load changes means what? Suppose if load increases or reduces or whatever, okay, irrespective of load changes, if I want to maintain transformer core flux constant, what we have to do? Very simple. See, if I want only this black color flux in the transformer core, this green color flux and this red color flux, that should be cancelled, no? Yes or no? So if you observe clearly, guys, this green color flux direction and red color flux direction, nothing but pi 2 dash and pi 2, they are opposite direction. If you observe clearly, direction of this pi 2 dash, this arrow mark, and direction of pi 2, this arrow mark is opposite. That means they are already out of phase. They are already out of phase. If you equate their magnitudes, so automatically they will cancel with each other, then only this core flux pi only will remain in the transformer core. So ultimately, what is our conclusion? In primary side, this pi dash is corresponding to I2 dash current, which is flowing in primary side. Pi 2 dash in primary side magnitude should be equal to this pi 2 is because of this I2 current, okay, which is flowing in a secondary winding. So this pi 2. So magnitude of pi 2 dash and pi 2 should be equal. Then only, so since they are already out of phase, okay, they will cancel with each other. Now tell me, so how can you equate their magnitudes? You tell me, what is the formula for flux? Flux equals to MMF by reluctance. What is that? MMF by reluctance. Let me show with the S. MMF is what? Number of turns into current by reluctance. So obviously flux is because of what? I can say MMF. So please tell me, pi 2 dash is because of which MMF? See, pi 2 dash is related to primary winding. Don't confuse, because pi 2 dash flux, this green color flux, is due to I 2 dash, which is flowing in a primary side. So what are the number of turns in the primary side? N1. So I said, what is the formula for MMF? Flux, I mean, what is the formula for MMF? A number of turns into current, no? So I had taken number of turns N1, and now tell me, what is the current due to which I'll get this pi 2 dash, I 2 dash. Okay. So I'm using same color, at least try to see that colors so that you'll be having some clarity. Okay. Equal to. So now tell me, pi 2 is the flux I got because of which current? See, I just used this red color. Because of which current? I 2. I 2 is the current flowing in which winding? Secondary winding. So secondary number of turns? N2. N2. And what is the current due to which pi 2 is produced here? I2. N2 I2. Is it clear, guys? So ultimately this is the condition. N1 I1 dash is equals to N2 I2 dash. N1 I2 dash is equals to N2 I2. This is the condition, to be frank, exact condition for what? For maintaining transformer core flux constant irrespective of load changes. So let me write here that point here. This condition, nothing but what? Exact condition to maintain transformer as constant flux device. Irrespective of load changes, okay? Right. So what is the meaning? See, if you observe clearly, Suppose if I2 increases, guys, if load increases, load means what? I can say current only, no? If load increases means I2 increases. Whenever I2 increases, pi2 increases. Because of this pi2 only, you know, you'll get some EMF in primary winding. I call it as EZ. Because of that EMF, you'll get some current I2 dash. Is it clear? So whenever I2 increases, pi2 increases. And because of pi2, you'll get some EMF in primary winding EZ that increases. Current I2 dash increases. Once again, pi2 dash increases. They're already out of phase. If you equate their magnitudes, they will cancel with each other. Therefore, if load increases or reduces, whatever, if you maintain this condition, transformer transformer core plus remains a constant irrespective of load changes. Exact condition to maintain transformer as constant flux device irrespective of load changes. Okay, guys. Now one more thing, guys. You please tell me what is the formula for primary winding current? You know, I1 bar. I can say I1 bar equal to I told you already, I naught plus I2 dash. This only I wrote, this one or this one, whatever, okay? So guys, now tell me, what is the value of this I naught value? I naught value, I'm asking. 5 to 6% of full load current. It's very less value, no? 5 to 6% of full load current. If you compare with I2 dash, this current is very less. If I neglect this I naught, okay, in place of I2 dash bar, what you can write here simply I1 bar you can write. That means, please let me write here I N1 in place of I2 dash, what I can write here I1 is equals to remaining as it is N2 I2. So N1 I1 means what? Primary MMF, I can say primary MMF. N2 I2 means what? Secondary MMF. Is it clear? So primary MMF equal to secondary MMF. This is the once again condition for maintaining transformer as a constant flux device irrespective of load changes, but not exact, it's approximate condition. Why? Because in place of I2 dash, I am writing I1 by neglecting what? By neglecting I0. Okay. So let me write that one also. This is what I can say, approximate condition. What is that? Approximate condition. Remaining thing as it is, to maintain transformer as constant flux device irrespective of load changes. This remaining portion as it is, okay guys? Okay, so I'll come to this one once again. So here, you please try to let me show like this. Initially, I just showed direction of 5 mu means this arrow marks indicates direction of 5 mu current. And in the form of cross and dot, I indicated, you know, in the form of cross and dot also, I indicated like cross and dot. Like that here also, I2 means, I told you it is entering at the back end, leaving at front end. This arrow marks. Leaving at front end. Okay. That means, see, so if you observe clearly, this I2, I told you already, pi2, if I want upward direction, I2 should have entered, I2 might have entered back end with this one only, no? So it is entering at back end, it is leaving at front end, see, entering, leaving. See, if I want pi2 upward, I2 might have flown, I2 might have entered like this, no? That means I2 is entering at back end. Okay, so that one I just showed here, but let me show in the form of cross and dot, that's it, okay? Because I just forget to keep here dot and cross, I'm just indicating, that's it, okay? So I2 means it is entering at back end, like this you have to show, means entering, leaving, okay? This cross is the direction of I2 which is entering here, dot, entering, leaving, okay? Right, so just like this, I'm just indicated a direction of I2 also in the form of dot and cross. Since he is entering at back end, so entering at back end means here cross, here dot, okay, right. Right, now please come back to our this topic here, see this relation. So tell me guys, what is the exact condition for maintaining transformer as a constant flux device? N1 I2 dash equals to N2 I2, okay. What is the approximate condition for maintaining transformer as a constant flux device? By neglecting I naught, in place of I2 dash, I can write I1, then it becomes N1 I1 equals to N2 I2. Okay, guys. So if you observe clearly, this N1 I1 equals to N2 I2, I got N1 I1 equal to N2 I2, okay, which will be equal to what I can say, transformation ratio K. Transformation ratio K. So what is the formula for transformation ratio K in terms of N? I already told you in EMF equation of a transformer, please try to refer once. There I told what is the formula for transformation ratio K in terms of N? N2 by N1. See, that means N I have taken here. N2 by N1, okay, which is equal to what I can say, I will take this I2 here. I1 by I2, I1 by I2. This is the formula for transformation ratio. Already in EMF equation I told for transformation ratio formula, K equal in terms of E means E2 by E1, and I wrote in terms of N also N2 by N1, and now we got in this topic, I got N2 by N1 equals to, in terms of current also I got I1 by I2, I1 by I2. So please try to conclude this K formula also. So K equal to what? E2 by E1, N2 by N1, and I1 by I2. Okay guys. Now, so what is the conclusion here? What is the exact condition for maintaining transformer as a constant flux device irrespective of load changes? N1 I2 is equal to N2 I2. This relation only you have to use. Is it clear? Suppose if in the question, if they say I naught is neglected, or if they say I mu is neglected, then in place of I2 dash I can write I1. In place of I2 dash I can write I1. Then it becomes N1 I1 equals N2 I2. So please try to be very careful. If they say that I mu is neglected, then only you can use this relation. If they say that I mu, or I can say I naught is neglected, if it is ideal transformer, I told you already, ideal transformer means what? Where I mu is 0 and I naught is 0. Then only you can use this relation for condition for maintaining transformer as a constant flux device. Suppose if I mu is there, if I naught is there, then this is the condition you have to follow, not this one. Okay, please try to be very careful. Okay guys, now so this is the thing. Now see, but to be frank, so in the next video we are going to discuss about effect of leakage flux. So before going to that video, let me give some small information, little information regarding the video which I'm just going to tell in the next session. So very simple guys, see, I told you, if I maintain this condition, this or this, I told you that 100% pi dash and 100% pi 2 will cancel. So though I am saying, but actually it won't happen because see, every flux will be having two components. What is that? What are those two components? Let me take pi dash. It will be having two components, nothing but pi L1 means what? Leakage flux component of pi 2, leakage flux component of pi 2 dash, I call it as pi L1. And what is the other component? Mutual flux component of pi 2 dash, nothing but I can take it as pi 2 dash M. Among this leakage and mutual, leakage flux component will be around 5%, whereas a mutual flux component will be around 95%. Total gives you 100% pi 2 dash. Similarly, if you take a pi 2, so here also we'll be having two components. I can say pi L1, nothing but leakage plus component, self leakage plus component of pi 2, and mutual plus component of pi 2. This will be around 5% as I told you, and this will be around 95%. So though I said that if we maintain primary MMF equal to secondary MMF, I said ideally this pi dash and pi 2 will cancel 100%. To be frank, it won't. Only if you maintain this condition, only mutual flux components only will cancel. Nothing but this pi dash M, nothing but mutual flux component of pi dash, this will cancel with pi to M, mutual flux component of pi to, this will cancel. So what is the meaning of for this mutual flux component and leakage flux components? Very simple. I already told you, leakage flux means flux that links with either low voltage winding or high voltage winding, but not both, is called leakage flux. Is it clear? Example, if you see, this pi L1 is there. It comes under pi dash. It is a sub of, I can say, pi dash flux only, no? So tell me, what is the direction of pi dash? This green color I am saying, this green color, see? This one, this green color direction is the direction of pi 2 dash. Is it clear, guys? Okay. So I told that 100% flux is started from here and it is leading. I mean 100% flux is coming and linking with the secondary, like that I am saying. To be frank, it won't happen. Out of 100%, only 95% flux only will come here, nothing but this. This pi dash m only will come. 95% of pi dash will come from primary winding to secondary winding. Is it clear? Whereas what about this 5% leakage flux? It won't come to that side. So it links with only this winding and takes path through the air. Takes path through the air. That means it won't come, it won't link with both windings. It links with only one winding. Example, if you see pi L1, which is related to which comes under pi 2 dash. Pi 2 dash is due to which current? I2 dash. I2 dash is flowing in a primary winding. So pi L1 links with only this winding. It won't come and link with secondary winding. So example, see, pi L1 is coming like this. Yes, it is coming. So I'll So pi L1 direction will be just like pi L1 direction also will be just like your pi 2 dash only, because it is comes under pi 2 dash only, you know. So let me show here. So don't confuse, I'm just going to draw the direction of pi L1. So just like pi 2 dash, it is also coming like this. It is also coming like this. Direction of pi L1 will be just like pi 2 dash. See this arrow mark upwards. Direction of pi 2 dash is upwards. Now I am just showing pi L1 direction also upwards. It is coming and it won't, it link with only this winding. It won't come and link with that winding. Okay. So after reaching here, it takes path through the air. Here air is there. See here. It takes path through the air. It is coming like this. It is taking path through the air. It won't come that side. Similarly, see, if you want, I can show this side here also. It is also here also, here is there, no? So this pi L1 is coming like this. Okay, like this, coming, and once again it won't come to secondary side. It takes path through the air like this. So this is what direction of, I can say, pi L1. Okay guys, suppose if I place some points here, so please try to tell answer to the question, because this is a question asked in one PSU. All right, if I give some points like example x and y, okay, so they'll ask you question like this. What is the instantaneous, this word is very important guys, in this example I am saying, what is the instantaneous direction of a flux pi L1? I am asking instantaneous direction of flux pi L1. So you'll get options, in option A they'll get x to y, and option B they'll get y to x, like that they'll give. So tell me, is it, whether it is x to y or y to x? So it is from x to y. See, instantaneous means it is coming and leaving here only. After taking path through the air, immediately, so it is going initially to point x, then it will go to point y, no? That means your answer is from x to y. But some people will think like this, sir, y to x also correct? No. How? See, sir, it is started here. Y is coming, sir. Coming. Yes, going to x, no? See, if you see from outside, it is going from y to x also. But don't go for option y to x. You please go for option x to y, because I said instantaneous. After taking path to the air, initially, it is going to which point? X point. Then it is going to y point. Then that means answer is what? X to y, not y to x. Instantaneous direction of flux pi L1 is from x to y. X to, this point is nothing but x, and this is nothing but y. I can say x to y. It is not from y to x. Don't see here from y to x like this. Don't see. Instantaneous means you have to see after, immediately, whenever flux is coming to air, then you have to see initially it is coming to point x, then it will go to point y. So you should go for option x to y, not y to x. Okay, like that. Here also, if you see here also, your pi L1 is coming, is leaving like this. Yes, taking path like this. So now after reaching immediately, so they'll give some examples like a W and a Z, like something like that, W and Z. Now tell me answer. Instantaneous direction of flux phi L1. I means what? Is it W to Z or Z to W? It is from W to Z. Instantaneous means after reach, after taking path A, it is coming initially to point W, then will come to Z, means W to Z. Don't say that sir Y to Z also. It says if you don't say that Z to W, because so from here it is going sir, going and coming to W, like that. Don't say answer like Z to W. It is from W to Z only. Instantaneous means after reaching, after taking path of the area, initially it is going to W point, then it will go to Z point. So answer is W to Z, not from Z to W. Don't say Z to W. It is from W to Z. Okay guys, don't say Z to W. Please say W to Z. That's it. Okay guys, like that. So what I said, this pi L1 leakage flux won't come but link with the secondary winding. Is it clear? So it will be linking with only, I can say that primary winding only. So because of this pi L1 leakage, it won't cancel. This will pi, whereas pi dash will cancel. Is it clear? So it won't cancel. Because of this pi L1, so what is the other name for leakage flux? Useless flux. What is that other name for leakage flux? Useless flux. Because of this leakage flux, pi L1, you'll get some EMF induced in a primary winding, EX1. I can call it as EX1. Nothing but useless EMF induced in the primary side, which should be compensated. Similarly, guys, in the secondary side also, as I told you, pi 2m, nothing but mutualist component. It is linking with the secondary winding as well as the primary winding also. Because mutualist component, no? It is linking with both the secondary and primary. But what about pi L1? Is nothing but leakage flux, no? See, if you maintain this condition, this will cancel with this. Whereas this will be there in primary side. Pi L1 will be there. 5% leakage flux will be there in primary side. So that because of that leakage flux, you'll get some EMF, useless EMF in the primary side EX1. Similarly, because of this pi L1 leakage flux in secondary side, it won't cancel. It will be there. But this one is cancelling with this one. But this will be there and this will be there. Now tell me guys. So this pi L1, nothing but I can write pi L2 guys, because I already given name for this pi L1. So I'll read it as pi L2. Okay. This pi L2 links with only secondary winding, because pi L2 comes under pi 2. Pi 2 is because which got I2. I2 is a current flowing in secondary side. So pi L2 is linking with only secondary. It won't come and link with the primary. So let me show like this direction for pi L2 also. So tell me pi L2 comes under which flux? Pi 2. So what is the direction of pi 2? This red color one, you know? Yes. Just like this red color flux pi 2, pi L2 also coming and it will link with the secondary winding. But after linking with the secondary winding, it won't come to primary. It takes path through the air like this. This is what direction of pi L2 I can say. Is it clear guys? Similarly, so if you want inside also I can show. See direction of pi L2 is upwards, no? Yes, upwards. Let me show here upward direction. Don't confuse by seeing this arrow marks, because I just going step by step. Right now please see. So this is what I can say, direction of what I said, pi L2. Okay. So 5% leakageless component pi L2 links with only secondary winding. It won't come and link with the primary winding. So in primary side, 5% leakage flux pi L1 will be there. In second side, 5% leakage flux pi L2 will be there. Because of this pi L1, useless EMF EX1 will be induced in primary side. Because of this pi L2, useless EMF EX2 will be induced in a secondary side also. This EX1 and EX2 should be compensated. So how you have to compensate this EX1, EX2 means that only we are going to see in the next video. Effect of leakage flux. See, because of leakage flux, some useless EMFs EX1 in primary side, because of this leakage flux EX2 in secondary side will be induced. So that EX1 comma EX2 should be compensated. So that we are going to discuss in the next video, how we are going to, you know, how this EX1 comma EX2, how we have to compensate all those things, we'll see in the next video. Okay. So do you please do one thing, guys. Just write some points here. Yeah, for this video I'm saying, just note on. Please note on. Yeah, by keeping primary MMF equal to secondary MMF, by keeping primary MMF equal to secondary MMF, 100% pi dash, 100% pi dash will not cancel with 100% pi 2. 100% pi 2 dash will not cancel with 100% pi 2. Will not cancel with 100% pi 2. Full stop. 5% leakage plus component of 5% leakage plus component of pi 2 dash. 5% leakage plus component of pi 2 dash. What is the name for that, guys? What is the leakage plus component of pi dash? Pi L1, no. So let me give here, let me give that point. 5% leakage plus component of pi dash in bracket. Pi L1 and 5% leakage plus component of and 5% leakage plus component of and 5% leakage plus component of pi 2 in bracket pi L2 will not cancel. I said will not cancel. Full stop. Yeah, next point. Mutual flux component of pi dash. I can write, if you want, you can note on that, you can add something word, some word here. 95% of, please try to use that 95% also. 95% of mutual flux component of pi dash. 95% of mutual flux component of pi dash in bracket. Pi 2 dash m will cancel with 95% of mutual plus component of pi 2, 95% of mutual plus component of pi 2, you can write in bracket pi 2 m. What I said here, 95% of mutual plus component of pi dash, nothing but pi 2 dash m, will cancel with 95% of mutual plus component of pi 2 in bracket pi 2 m. Full stop. So tell me, what are the components which will not cancel? Leakage fluxes components will not cancel, whereas mutual fluxes components will cancel. Okay, guys, full stop. Let's note on one point. Yeah, because of pi L1 comma pi L2, useless EMFs, EX1, you just write like this, E suffix X1, because of pi L1 comma pi L2, EX1 and EX2 will be induced in primary and secondary sites respectively. Full stop. These EX1 comma EX2 should be compensated. This EX1 comma EX2 should be compensated, which we will discuss in topic, just note on the topic name, which we'll discuss in topic, effect of leakage flux on the operation of transformer, effect of leakage flux on the operation of transformer. Okay guys, please try to note down this. In the next video I'm just going to start effect of leakage flux on the operation of transformer. There I'll tell you how we have to compensate this EX1, EX2. Okay, thank you.